In this lesson number 6, I'm gonna show how to play the root, third, fifth walking bassline from lesson 5 in all keys. So it's more a lesson for the left hand, but these are essential patterns which you can play whenever you need a boogie-woogie-like walking bassline or as a pre-exercise for a more complicated bassline, which I'm gonna show you in later lessons. As I said, in this lesson I'm gonna show a root, third, fifth walking bassline or a root, third, fifth, third bassline, respectively. By the way, when a chord instrument plays exactly these three notes, the root, the third and the fifth, it's a major chord. When you play it from an open string root note, for example A, it goes like this. The root is the open A string. The third is on the fourth fret, same string. The fifth is on the second fret, next higher string. And back to the fourth fret A string. The same pattern works also if the root note is on the E. Open E for the root note, fourth fret for the third, second for the fifth. And it works also if the root note is a D. The same pattern will not work for the G, for the open G, but if you wait a few minutes, I'm gonna show you how it works. The next pattern is for the root note on the first fret. Let's start with F. Many rock and roll songs are in the key of F because it's a good horn key. Grab the note F on the E string, first fret with your index. The third is on the next string, open. The third is always one fret lower from the root on the next string. And the fifth is the C, next string, A string, third fret. The same pattern works if the root note is a B flat. First fret A string, open D string, third fret D string. And it will work for the D sharp or the E flat. This note has two names. The next logical step is a pattern where the root note is on the second fret. Let's start with F sharp or G flat. Grab the note with your attention middle finger. This is the second fret. This is our root note. For the third, grab the note on the next string, first fret. And for the fifth, take your pinky and grab the C sharp, fourth fret. Is between third and fifth. And because the bass strings are very thick, and because we want to slap the notes, it's often necessary to support the pinky with the ring finger or with other fingers. So press the string with your pinky and your ring finger. This works also for the B. Or for the E. This is an absolutely movable pattern. You can use it for every major chord when the root is located on the 2nd fret and higher. So if you want to play this walking bass over a G major chord, start with the low G on the E string 3rd fret as your root. The 3rd is the B, and the 5th is the D. But in this special case, you can play the 5th open. Also, if the root note is the C, you can play this movable pattern. But you can also play the 5th, which is the G open. But for the F, for the high F, you need this movable pattern. And if you want to play this boogie line in the key of G sharp, you need also the movable pattern. So if you want to play a 12 bar blues in D, play the 1 chord, the D, in the open version. The 4th chord is the G, played like this. And the 5th chord, the A, goes like this. So the whole 12 bar blues goes like this. For 12 bar blues in F, you have two options. You can play the F pattern like this, or like this. Please practice only one pattern first, and if you're comfortable with it, start with the next pattern. These are very conventional and important patterns, and you can use them in many rockabilly songs. And they are a very good exercise for patterns over two measures that will follow in one of the next lessons. Hope you had fun. Thanks for watching and bye bye.